Hey, this is Jay Lee from LA UFO Channel. Just want to show you guys how to spot a fake UFO video right now. Hi, this is Jay Lee. Hope all is well. I just wanted to go over how to spot a fake UFO video. I think people think that we have to send the video over to some sort of CGI expert or some sort of video forensic specialist, analyst to check out the video. But, you know, really, honestly, this is not necessary in probably 90-95% of the cases. When I hear people who captured prolific UFO footage say that they are going to remain anonymous because they are afraid of the ridicule they will receive, that is a tip-off for me that it's fake. What people think will not change what they saw and what they captured on video, and they certainly can't change what they know. If you've captured a smoking gun in ufology, who cares what people think? So bottom line, it comes down to this. The reason why people with prolific UFO footage want anonymity is because when people find out that it's fake, it will ruin their personal reputation. This brings up another good point. The big UFO channels perpetuating the hoax. What do they say? They say, "This was just sent to me anonymously. Don't get mad at me if it's fake. I'm just the messenger." They are hiding under the guise of UFO news. But in all reality, as a channel that brings a hungry UFO public the latest UFO footage, it's irresponsible for them not to do their due diligence and scrutinize what they see personally. They should absolutely make sure that there is a responsible party. People should be given information on how to contact the person who took the video so they can either be famous or infamous. Either way, they'll go down in history as a famous videographer or a scumbag hoaxer. And I think that this is one of the problems. There's no impunity when they lie. There's no punishment or consequences. So bottom line, this is what it kind of comes down to. UFO propaganda substituting for the facts makes toxic beliefs. Now I get the hacker that hacks into NASA's secret computer and pulls pictures and videos. I also get the ex-government worker that steals video footage from his boss's computer and sends it to the news agency in a manila folder. I get the reasons for anonymity, but the person who videotapes a landed UFO at night in an open field? Or how about the guy who just happens to be capturing video through his airplane window and captures prolific UFO footage? How come they want to be anonymous? It's stupid, and to me, very obvious. In order for me to determine a UFO video is fake or not, I use the acronym CARR, C-A-R-R. All of the letters and words are basically the same and lean in one direction. C stands for credibility, A stands for accountability, R stands for responsibility, and the other R stands for reputation. If you look at some of the most prolific UFO sightings in ufology with pictures and video, you'll see that there's a name attached. And that's the difference between the real and fake UFOs, the fact that people will put their reputation on the line. When you start hearing excuses on why they are remaining anonymous, it's an indication of a hoax. There is such an electronic paper trail with the internet, the hoaxers are afraid to post. Therefore, they remain anonymous. When I find out that someone sent their video directly to the big UFO channel, or what I call the boofock, that tells me that it might be self-manufactured in order to get hits. Hits mean money. If you take a look at the number of hits these fake videos get, it's amazing. These guys literally get millions of hits. These guys aren't stupid, but they pander to credulous people. If the person who filmed the UFO did not put it on their personal YouTube channel or Facebook page, guaranteed it's fake. Some people, after they captured a UFO, will put their name on the video footage. This is an indication that it's personal property that's being shared. So if you see a boofock show a UFO video with a watermark label on it, that's an indication that it's personal property bought and paid for by the big UFO channel and they are not sharing the revenue. When you see a boofock with a watermark label on it, it should lose all credibility with you. You know that it's fake. What's funny to me is that when a big UFO channel will attribute the video to an obscure name in an obscure location but will not cite the YouTube or Facebook page they got it from, guess what that means? It's fake. This is also an indication that they are probably sharing revenue with the person who actually constructed the video. It's really disgusting, but like I said, it panders to the stupid or the credulous, mocks those who know it's true, and betrays the UFO community. Hey, I just want to apologize to those who have to go back and take a second look at their favorite UFO videos. I have to admit that some of my favorite UFO videos fall into this hoax category. I find generally most of us are looking for that UFO Grand Slam footage that will prove once and for all that aliens are here. Just to let you know that they are, but also know that UFOs may look different than what you expect. Understanding is the key. Another thing I wanted people to get from this video is that the debunker shouldn't go after people who are looking up in the sky and doing UFO field researching. The people who put their name and reputation on the line should have their footage scrutinized with an open mind. If what they captured defies the laws of physics or displays abnormal characteristics of normal aerial debris, it should be acknowledged and examined. The debunkers should spend their time going after the money-making websites that perpetuate the UFO myth with phony, anonymous UFO fake video. It's as if the UFO community punishes those who take accountability and responsibility for their footage and rewards those scumbags that make anonymous fake UFO videos. This is Jay Lee from LA UFO Channel. Come join us at our UFO sighting events. Join LA UFO Channel on meetup.com, give us a thumbs up, and subscribe to this channel. And we'll see you next time.